Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us on this Facebook Live, our inaugural episode of Dialogue with the Dean. I'm Dan Bolson. I serve as the College of Pharmacy's Senior Director of Development. I've had the privilege of meeting many of you and look forward to meeting those of you that I have not met working on our alumni team. I have the privilege of introducing this series. This is a series that the college has put in place to hopefully give you, the alumni, our students watching, our faculty, staff, a little bit more of an insight into specific topics. And one thing that Eric does, great as Dean, is he does the First Friday videos, but sometimes there's topics within those videos that we don't have a chance to expound more on. So this series will hopefully give you a little insight into a variety of topics over the course of the next few months, as hopefully we can make this a monthly Facebook Live. Please take advantage of the fact that we are live by using your phone, your iPad, your tablet, your computer to submit questions. At the end of this session, I'll pop back in, and if you've submitted questions and time allows, I will try to make sure that we can get those asked of Dean Barker and April Hetty as well. So with that, I will turn this over to Eric to talk about our first Dialogue with the Dean topic, which is President's Council Naples event in 2019. From February 14th through the 17th, we'll be down in Naples. So with that, Eric, the floor is yours.
Thanks, Dan, and I, again, thank you for joining us on this new medium for us to communicate important topics for the College of Pharmacy and things that are going on here at Purdue University. It's my pleasure to have with me today a special guest, April Hetty, who is the Assistant Vice President for Donor Relations with Purdue Research Foundation and Purdue University. April, welcome to the College of Pharmacy.
Thank you. We're glad
that you could come over this afternoon and be with us and talk a little bit about President's Council, PC, the Naples weekend. And so for those who haven't heard about the Naples President's Council weekend event, what's it all about?
Well, other than the opportunity of leaving cold weather and heading to sunny, warm Florida, bringing the Boilermakers there, it's a great time for alums from all over to come in and have experience Purdue on the road. We have a golf outing where we partner with the John Purdue Club. It's their annual Mollenkopf Keys Classic. We also provide classes for folks to jump in and kind of hear a little bit of what's happening at Purdue. We do a Women for Purdue Giving Circle. We have time with the deans, of course, and then we also celebrate our annual appreciation dinner.
Great. Over there. Well, it last year was my first year to attend. It's just a great time to be together. Who usually attends, though?
Oh, we have alumni and friends, anybody that really truly cares about Purdue and wants to learn more about the university or just celebrate what it means to be a Boilermaker, from all over the country.
So if you were speaking to pharmacy alums, which we are today, why would you tell a pharmacy alum that they should actually come?
Well, to hear from you, of course. There's opportunities to, in addition to have one-on-one time with you, but to network with fellow pharmacy alums and other university administrators and alumni.
One of the things we talk about here in the College of Pharmacy is about being the Purdue Pharmacy family, but that we're a part of that larger Purdue family, and it really is exciting to be together as Boilermakers. And it doesn't hurt that it's in a nice warm spot in February, but it really is a great opportunity to network with other Boilermakers and have that common bond that we experience here from Purdue University. So I'm sure there's a lot of people out there that have never attended, have always kind of wondered about it, heard about it. What could a new attendee expect to get out of the weekend?
Sure, absolutely. Well, we have our traditional setting that we typically have a breakfast with the deans. We offer back-to-class sessions where, again, they can hear from many of the faculty on campus and some of the research that's taking place. They can golf and attend our annual appreciation dinner, which has the president as our star. He'll give some university updates there. But also new this year, we're having an active track. The reason we brought the active track here is we're encouraging young alums to give it a try, to come to Naples and see what we have to offer in this great weekend. So the active track is geared towards those that want to get outside of the classroom. They want to kayak. We have airboat tours through the Everglades. We have a beach party as well that we'll have happening, and many other activities that were probably going to be of interest to some of our younger alums.
So are the deans allowed to come to the beach party?
Absolutely. All are welcome.
And on this
the airboat tour.
Airboat tour of the Everglades. We've got snake and alligator repellent, right?
Absolutely. It's part of the gift
package. This dean does not do snakes, and large snakes, like in the Everglades particularly. Is there anything else that'll be new this year?
Well, other than this year for our annual appreciation dinner, we are celebrating Purdue's 150th birthday. It is sure to be a wonderful event, chocked with many university updates, as well as some magical activities that you have to come to see.
Okay, well, you've piqued my interest. many people may hear about President's Council, but real quickly, do you have to be a member of President's Council to come? And just so that folks know, what does it take to be a member of President's Council?
Absolutely. You do not have to be a member of President's Council to come, but we encourage you to be a member because it's really important to the university, that support. To become a member, it's a simple gift of $1,000 annually to anywhere in the university, whether they want to give to the College of Pharmacy, to any of the pharmacy student organizations, or any other area on campus. That's all it takes. And we like to say for $85 a month, if you pledge that, you can immediately become a President's Council member.
Great. Well, just a reminder, particularly for many of our pharmacy alums, if you happen to work for a company that does a one-to-one match, there's an opportunity to join President's Council with your $500 and then a $500 match from your employer. You can actually be a member of the President's Council, and that's a great way to get introduced to President's Council. And we'd encourage you to explore that if your employer by chance does matching program.
Sure.
Any questions for me?
Yes. I shared with you what's happening on our end. Okay. Why don't you tell us what pharmacy has planned?
Well, we will, for those that golf, we will be at the golf event, mm-hmm. and I will be there, and Dan and other alums. We're already beginning to assemble some pharmacy foursomes, and we're excited about that. The breakfast with the deans on Saturday morning, I will be there and I'll share a very brief update for the group. It really is an opportunity many times for the deans to share news with the alums and for them to hear things for the very, very first time. And so it's an opportunity to get a sneak peek on some things. There will be a watch party, and we'll be at the watch party, which is the Penn State game on that Saturday afternoon. Mm-hmm. We'll be at the President's Council dinner. We'll have pharmacy tables. At the dinner will be there, and then especially for pharmacy alums, we will have a brunch on Sunday afternoon, and there'll be information coming out about that. But Sunday, I think at 11 a.m., we'll have a brunch, and we'll be together as the Purdue Pharmacy family. It'll be an opportunity for me to share a couple of things. One, we've just passed this week our new strategic plan, and I'll be sharing some new initiatives where we're investing in our academic programs, our ability and part of our mission to drive and lead innovations in pharmacy practice, new areas in research, new opportunities for alumni engagement, as well as how we're enhancing our student experience. And then beyond that, the big initiative for us this year is a really important initiative around our facilities. We have aging facilities. This building that we're in, most people, I have to remind them that the new pharmacy building is now 50 years old, we have a real issue with our facilities, and in particular, almost all of our Big Ten peers have better facilities than us, and that hurts us in our recruitment for the very best faculty and very best students, and the very best students go on to be the very best alumni.
Absolutely.
And so we have a new initiative called the Future for Pharmacy Initiative. There's a website for that, the Purdue Future for Pharmacy Initiative with the number 4, PurdueFutureForPharmacy.com.
Okay.
And they can go there, find out about it, but we'll be talking about that initiative as well. So
great.
That's going to be what we're going to cover when we're together.
Fantastic. Thank you.
So I think Dan's coming back in, but remind us, the website for PC Weekend is?
Absolutely. It's purdue.edu/PC for President's Council.
There you go. That's an easy one to remember, even for the old guy like me.
So, April, thank you so much for being here,
for
joining us.
A
question for those watching that wonder, you know, when do you encourage them to be signed up for PC Weekend? When do you encourage that deadline, and what is kind of the suggested deadline beyond just the hard deadline?
Well, thank you for asking. Of course, sign up as soon as possible, but you can sign up as late as the end of January. I will tell you, when you go out to the website, we do have hotel block information out there where we offer to folks. Those blocks expire, though, probably the second week of January, if I remember correctly. So you'll definitely want to get your reservation in as soon as possible.
Eric, thank you for your time as well. And thank you to all of you who've tuned in to watch. It's been great to see the response we've gotten so far, and look forward to those of you that may watch this in its recorded version that'll live live on our pharmacy Facebook page from here on. So thanks again. The happiest of holidays from our family to yours. The College of Pharmacy truly is a family. We take a privilege of being a part of it and bringing some insider things to you and having you get involved with us. If you have any questions regarding anything you've heard today, please feel free to email myself, John Dinkins, my counterpart, who is not here today, but obviously is our team leader on the Chief Development Officer side of the college, or Eric as well. You can email any of us, and we'd be happy to respond to you. April, thank you again.
Thank you.
Eric, thank you. Please tune in next month for a different topic with Dialogue with the Dean. We've got a plan for hopefully bringing you some exciting content, and we look forward to engaging with you more. So, happiest of holidays to you, and boiler up.
Boiler up, and Happy New Year.